are going to perform this experiment to measure the area of irregular shape. If the object is irregular, already I have told you, if to measure the area of regular shape means if there is a rectangle, triangle, square, then we have a particular formula. Am I right? But if the object is irregular, means which does not have a proper shape, then we have to measure the area of irregular shape by using the graph paper. So my dear students, so see, this is a graph paper. So you have to draw. Let's do the activity. So you have to draw just outline of this leaf. This is a irregular in shape. After drawing the outline, you have to measure this, means you have to measure this full square. First you are going to measure the full square, then half square, and more than half square. So let's measure the full square. So this is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. This will come 26, 27. So there are total 27 full squares. So I'm going to write here 27. Then half square. So half means what? If you have to find which is the half here, so this is a half one. So I will mark with a red pen, so it will be easy. One. And then this is more than half. This is more than half. This is also more than half. More than half. This is half. So two. This is, we have to neglect the which are less than half. This is more than half. This is also more than half. Three. So there are only two. So I will write here two. And now let's find more than half. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You have to ignore this. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and this one 13. So there are total 13 more than half. So you have to add this. So 7 plus 2, 9, 9 plus 2, 3, 12, and 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 1, 4. So area of this irregular shape, is 42 square unit. So this area will be 42 square unit will be the area of this irregular shape. So like that, by using any kind of the leaf, you can measure the area of irregular shape. For MCQ, they are asking the question to measure the area of irregular shape, then what we have to use? Yes, we have to use the graph paper. So I hope you have understood this experiment. Let's move to the second experiment. To measure the circumference of the pencil. Now I don't have here. We can use your pen. To measure the circumference, see, similarly to measure the thickness of a thread, we can use this. So for this, you have to wrap this. You have to wrap this thread. You have to take at least 10 round. So 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we can see 1, 2. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And this is 10 round. Okay. So there are total 10 rounds. Now you have to measure this thing with the help of the scale. So this is a scale. With the help of it, I'm going to measure this length. So it is coming approximately 1.8. Okay. So length is coming. Length is 1.8. And how many turns we have taken? 10. How many turns we have taken? 10. So when you will divide this 1/8 divided by 10, so answer is going to come. This is saying it is decimal, that is round. So this 0, when it will come up, it is going to be 0 point. This decimal point is going to shift left side. Am I right? So 0.18 centimeter. This was a calculate to measure the circumference of a pencil. So this was a to measure the circumference of a pencil. So let's start doing the third activity to measure the volume of irregular object. Now volume, you know, if the volume is cube, if the shape is cube, means if it has a proper shape, then by using the formula we can find the volume. But if the object is irregular, then what we have to do? See, this is what measuring cylinder. I'm going to use this as a rubber which is irregular in shape. Then in this I'm going to add a water. Suppose Yes, 40 ml. Here you are going to look at the water level of the water. It is a lower meniscus. This is lower meniscus. Meniscus means what? The lower line you can see. So it is called as a lower meniscus. If you are going to take a oil, then it is going to come like this. So it is means it is coming like this. So it will come upper meniscus. So here water, you have to see the lower meniscus, which is 40 ml. Then when I'm going to drop this irregular object in this, the automatically the level is going to increase. So it has been increased to the 48 ml. You can see 40, you can see this 45, and this up 3 ml, so it is coming 48 ml. So you can see how we have done for the broken scale. Similarly, the initial level was and final level was 48 ml. Therefore, to find the volume of irregular object, you have to subtract this final level minus initial level. So 48 minus 40, it is going to come 8 ml. Are you getting? So 8 ml is the volume of this irregular object. Are you getting this? I hope you have understood it. So try to perform these two activities, these two experiments at your home. So see, to measure the area of irregular object, you have understood. Now to measure the circumference of a pencil, this is circumference, this will be the circumference. Circumference is equal to length upon number of turns you have taken. So length is 1.8 and number of turns were 10. So circumference has came 0.18 centimeter. If you want a radius, this is the circumference. You know circumference means what? The outer area means, now see, this is the circumference. So this is the outer area, am I right? So you have to calculate. So by using the thread, you can calculate the circumference of a pen or pencil. Then to measure the volume of irregular object, by using this displacement method. So this method is called as a displacement method. Are you getting this? I hope you have understood it. Thank you.